minus 10, 9, 8.
The clock is
7,
operating. We're underway.
Tranquility Base, good.
Endeavor, go at throttle.
Back on here, we're about two minutes to the men's start. Back here at the USCSA National Championships, the men's 7.5 kilometer skate championship this morning.
I think it's worth noting that that's the first time Bob has actually gotten the USCSA abbreviation correct. So everybody, round of applause out there from the crowd. Yeah, there we go. All right, and if the women's race was any indication, we should be in for a great race on the men's side. We got a first person that's going to be up is going to be Parker Cushing. He's already heading up towards the starting wand. We are anxiously awaiting the kickoff of this race. 7.5K.
A little recap from this morning's races. Your top five in fifth place, Anna Johnson. In fourth place, Allison Shaken. In third place, Stephanie Ballas. In second place, Anna Witkowski. And your champion from this morning's women's 7.5K skate, Isabel Sharp from Cornell. Great racing this morning. We're looking for some great racing this afternoon coming here starting at 11 o'clock.
Minute and a half till the start. First person going off at 11 o'clock.
So temperatures have warmed up a little bit here. A little bit of change in the waxes. I saw a lot of the coaches over there fixing skis up, getting skis ready for their athletes. We have our 7.5K course again. 7.5K course heads out on a ladies 5K course, the Olympic ladies 5K course here at Lake Placid. Pretty hilly at the start for the first 5K. Then they'll come back into the stadium, head out for another 2.5K loop, finish up coming back in under the USCSA banner and archway.
All right, in the starting gate, bib number one, Parker Cushing, skiing for Colorado Mesa University. He's an economics major coming out of Lone Tree. All right, here we go. First racer out on course, Parker Cushing, bib number one. Next up, bib number two, Simon Stouffer, skiing for St. Olaf College, skiing for Kevin Brockman. He's a filmmaking major, Hidden Valley, his home mountain. And this is going to be his first national championship. Well, good luck, Simon. Heading out right now. Next up in the starting gate, bib number three, Raymond Metzger, skiing for the United States Air Force Academy. Coach's name, El Capitan. He's a foreign area studies major coming out of Anchorage, Alaska. And once again, a lot of first-time national champion competitors this year. This is going to be his first national championship. And he'd like everybody to know that once he did kind of okay at a community race back home. Bib number three, Raymond Metzger, out on course. Next up, bib number four, Luke Bodouz, skiing for Western State, coached by Duncan Callahan. His home mountain is Crested Butte, so he didn't go too far for college. Skiing at a high elevation up there, the thick air down here should feel pretty good. And once again, another competitor, first time national championship competitor. Bib number five, Devin Perry, skiing for Castleton University, skiing for Marty Mayer over there. He's an ecological studies major coming out of the skiing powerhouse, Honeyo Falls. And his home mountain is Bristol Mountain. Devin out on course. Next up, bib number six, Carl Froelich. He is coached by Isabel Sharp, who we just saw do very well in the women's 7.5K race. Carl's a biological engineering major out of Westford, and his home mountain is Great Brook Farms. This is going to be his first national championship.
Carl's out on course. Next up, we have bib number seven, Charlie Maitland. Charlie skis for Clarkson University, right up the road here. He hails from Shelburne, Vermont. Skis at Sleepy Hollow Ski and Bike Center. This is his second time competing. And he had a first place in the Eastern Regionals. And last year, he placed third place in the USCSA Nationals.
All right, Charlie out on course. Next up is going to be Lars Hallstrom in bib number eight, skiing for the University of Michigan. Abby Potts is his coach. I'm not quite sure how accurate that is, but he's a mechanical engineering major coming out of Ann Arbor, Michigan. And this is going to be his second national championship. Last year he was 14th in the sprint race, and he was 7th in the ski marathon out at Noquimenon. Gave it a try.
Good try, Jared. In the gate number nine, Andrew Siegel from the University of Vermont. He's a film and television studies major, and he's out of Bethel, Maine. It's his first time at the national championships. He doesn't have a home mountain. We're going to call his home Lake Placid, Mount Van Hovenberg.
All right, next up, Cal Lindberg, bib number 10. Coming in for his second national championship, skiing for Colorado Mesa University. He is a music with elective studies and business major coming out of Minnetonka, Minnesota. Cal, heading out on course.
Ian Sarazen's up next, bib number 11 from the United States Air Force Academy. He's an economics major, and he hails from Colchester, Vermont, over by the Ethan Allen Firing Range, great biathlon course that we have over in Vermont. It's his first time in national championship. He'd like to thank his brother Nigel for getting him here. Here you go, Ian, do this one for Nigel.
Nigel should be in line here somewhere. But next up, bib number 12, Nathan Maddox, coached by Duncan Callahan out there at Western State Colorado University. He's a business administration major from Eagle, Colorado. His home mountain is Vail, Colorado. And this is going to be, I believe, his fourth national championship.
See, Nathan's wearing our leader bib. So he won't have a regular bib on. He's number 12 on the start list, but he's wearing our leader bib. Leading the league in points right now.
All right, next up is going to be Thomas Clayton wearing bib number 13, skiing for University of Vermont. He's coached by Spike Clayton. He's a mathematics major coming out of Hinesburg, Vermont. His home mountain, like a few other people here, is Sleepy Hollow Ski and Bike Center. And this is going to be his third national championship.
He wants to thank Spike Clayton for waxing his skis. That's his dad. Hopefully he's waxed them fast today. Coming up next, bib 14 out of St. Olaf College. This is Matt Lynch. Matt's major is puppet arts. And his hometown is St. Louis Park, Rim Nordic Ski Area. He'd like to thank Carl Schaefer and Jim Wander for getting him out here. His favorite memory was when he broke his ski 100 meters from the finish. He had a scooter to the finish line. Matt's off and racing.
All right, next up we got bib number 15, David Harvey, skiing for Castleton University. Skiing for Marty Maher over there. He's a biology major from Lima, New York. And usually skis over at Mountaintop when he's at home. And this is going to be his second national championship. David heading out on course.
Another racer from that perennial power, Honey Eye Falls, Lima. Next up, we have Peter Mallory on course. Peter Mallory skiing for Clarkson University from Webster, New York, out near the Rochester area of New York State. This is his fourth national championship. He's got a 3.948 grade point average. Peter's off on course.
All right, next up we got bib number 17, Tyler Corville, skiing for Stanford University. He's coached by Cullen Cozy. He's majoring in, he's coming out of St. Ignatius, Montana, and his home mountain is East St. Mary's. This is going to be his first national championship, and we're hoping he comes up with a better bio next year.
Gotta love that race suit, though.
All right, Tyler Corville out on course.
Mason Vincent up next, bib 18. He's out of University of Wyoming. His hometown, Laramie, Wyoming. His home mountain is Pole Mountain. He's been to three national championships here. His favorite memory, and I remember this one, was last time in Lake Placid when the University of Wisconsin boys asked us to play All Day by Kanye.
Never again.
Never again will we do that.
All right, next up, bib number 19, Jordan Freed, skiing for the University of Maine at Farmington. Some great fishing up there at Farmington. His coach's name is Lauren Olson. He's an environmental science major coming out of Brookline, Massachusetts. And Mount Weston is his home mountain. This is going to be his second national championship. Jordan Freed out on course. And Tay Tantaviren, at least wearing something a little bit more appropriate than the last relay we saw him in. There we go.
Tay Tantaviren rocking it out here, coming back. You remember him last time in Lake Placid. He's from the University of Michigan. This is his second national championship. His career plans to save the world. Tay's got that going on. Tay's a mechanical engineering and German major, and he hails from Bangkok, Thailand. There he goes.
All right, bib number 21, Scott Bolt, skiing for Cornell University. He's coached by Isabel Sharp, a mechanical engineering major coming out of Potsdam, New York, one of the fewer places that's north of here. And his home mountain is the Higley Flow. This is going to be his first time national championship. First time at national championships. So good luck out there, Scott.
Jared, Canada's north of here.
It's not a place.
Yes, it is. Up next, number 22nd, hailing from Western State, Colorado University. Coached by Duncan Callahan, a recreation and outdoor education major from Washburn, Wisconsin. Kevin Geisen. He's had some great results. He's had a second, a fifth, a seventh, and a third overall. So he's looking for a top result here at these national championships. He's got a 3.7 GPA. His greatest memories are sharing the podium with his teammates. Kevin Geisen, out in course.
All right, next up in the gate, bib number 23, Andrew Quirk, skiing out of Stanford University. His coach is Kira Smiley. He's majoring in quinoa. And he's coming out of Wayzata, Minnesota. His home mountain is Elm Creek, and this is going to be his first national championship. I'm not quite sure how somebody majors in quinoa, but I guess we'll see if it helps. Andrew Quirk out on course.
Number 24, Josh Sayer heading out on course. He'll be next. Josh is an earth and atmospheric science major, and he's from Eugene, Oregon. And he skis out at Willamette Pass out there. His first national championship. He'd like to thank his high school coach, Charlie Wilshire. So Josh is doing this one for you, Charlie. Hope you're watching.
All right, getting into position at the start wand, Michael Giraldi, skiing for Clarkson University. He's a mechanical engineering major coming out of Bedford. His home mountain is Ledge Hill. This is going to be his first national championships. One of his favorite moments in USCSA racing is a Valentine's Day race at Divisionals.
We're not even going to ask what that's about.
Nope.
Keep your mind on the racing. Up next, number 26, Rowan Hall out of Colorado Mesa University. He's a geology major, and he hails from Alaska, long ways down up there. He skis at Beach Lake Ski Trails. This is his first national championships he's at here. Rowan Hall ready to head out on course, and he's off.
All right, next up we got Jared Wheeler wearing bib number 27. Great first name there, Jared. Skiing for Castleton University for Marty Maher. He's an exercise science major from Coventry, Rhode Island. And another one whose home mountain is Mountaintop. And this is going to be his first national championship. And since he hasn't listed any of his favorite moments in USCSA racing or academic highlights, throughout the week we will be making them up for him.
Jared is out on course. Bib 28, Ian McGuire out of Paul Smith College, right up this road here. His major is fisheries, and he's from Vernon, Connecticut. His home mountain, right here, Mount Van Hovenberg, so he knows these trails well. He's ready to go. This is his first national championships. Ian's ready to go. Loves this course, the ladies 5K. He's going to show us how it's done today. Ian McGuire on course.
All right, next up, Mitchell Holman wearing bib number 29, skiing for the United States Air Force Academy. Skis for Laura Abbott, the civil engineering major out of Waukesha, Wisconsin. And his home mountain, or home course, is Woodmore Golf Course. This is going to be his third national championship. And after graduation, he plans to be a civil engineer for the Air Force.
Up next, bib 30, Will Loeffner out of the University of Michigan. He's an environmental engineering major, and he hails from Midland, Minnesota. His home mountain is Snow Snake. It's his first time at the national championships here. Will's ready to go. Hailing from Michigan.
All right.
And Will's on course.
Next up, wearing bib number 31, Trevor Willoughby, skiing for the University of Wyoming. He's coached by Christy Boggs and Rachel Watson, and he's a business econ major coming out of Casper, Wyoming. This is going to be his third national championship. And it looks like he's done some great stuff in races named after the Game of Thrones. Trevor Willoughby out on course.
Trevor is heading out. You can see those University of Wyoming women up there waving those flags. I don't know where the rest of the teams are, but you better get out there and wave some flags and do some cheering. Wyoming's winning in that contest so far. Up next, number 32, Lucas Adamwitz is up next from the University of Vermont. He's a mechanical engineering major, hometown Burlington, New York, and he's out on course. This is his second national championships. Up next, bib 33, Spencer Ware-Junkus from St. Olaf College. He's an exercise science and German major. Coming out of St. Paul, Minnesota. Skis there at Battle Creek. This is his third national championships. And Spencer's out on course.
All right, next up, we're in bib number 34 in the even more recognizable Hunter Orange hat. Deer season might be over, but ski season is well underway. Connor Maryland, wearing bib number 34, skiing for the University of Maine at Farmington. Coached by Lauren Olson. He's a biology major out of Wrentham, Massachusetts.
You never be too careful, Jared. Always want to wear that bright yellow.
Orange.
Right, orange. Orange, you glad I said that? Up next, number 35 out of Marlboro College, Spencer Knickerbocker. Spencer is an economics major, and his hometown is Brattleboro, Vermont. He lists his coach's name as Spencer Knickerbocker. I don't know if that's his dad or him. It's his first time in a national championship. Spencer's ready to go, representing Marlboro College. And he's off.
All right, next up, wearing bib number 36, Tim Dunn, skiing for Clarkson University. He's an electrical engineering and computer science major coming out of Penfield, New York. Out in the Rochester area.
Starting to see some racers coming through. Our first racer through is going to be Parker Cushing, setting the pace here for the rest of the racers. Parker Cushing coming through the stadium right now, followed by Lucas Bodeweis.
All right, right out of the gate, or coming up to the gate, we have Nigel Sarazin, finally, the inspiration for his brother, skiing for the United States Air Force Academy. He's coached by Captain Laura Abbott.
There's Charlie Maitland heading through. Charlie ripping it up fast here today.
Charlie split at about 5K. It was right around 14 and a half minutes. Nigel Sarazin about to head out on course.
Devin Perry heading through. Devin Perry is heading through their lap lane here.
All right, next up in the starting gate, bib number 38, Owen Moland, skiing for the University of Vermont. He's coached by Spike Clayton. He's a biology major out of Bow, New Hampshire. This is going to be his second national championship. All right.
That's Andrew Siegel coming through over on the lap lane. Andrew skiing through, doing a nice job.
So far, Andrew's got the fastest split of the day by about 15 seconds. Next up in the starting area, we have bib number 39, Gordon Giannini, skiing for Western State Colorado University. He's a geology major out of Durango, Colorado. His home mountain is Crested Butte. This is going to be his third national championship. All right, coming through right now is bib number 3. That's going to be Raymond Metzger. Coming through is about 5K split in 1740.
Up next, bib 40, Thomas Wing out of the University of Maine at Farmington. He's an environmental science major, and he comes from New Sharon, Maine. And he skis at Titcomb Mountain up in Maine. It's a great ski area up there. He's coached by Lauren Olson. Thomas Wing out on course.
All right, next up, bib number 41, Kurt Huebner, skiing for Cornell University. Another of Isabel Sharp's athletes. He's a computer science major out of Grosse Pointe, Michigan. And his home mountain is Nubs Knob, Michigan. This is going to be his first national championship.
Up next, Tyler Radke. We don't have any information on Tyler, but Tyler's skiing for St. Olaf, and he'll be our next racer out on course.
All right, coming through just across the way, you might have just seen Lars Hallstrom and Nate Maddox come through the split. Nate Maddox slides up into the second position so far out of the 8 skiers that have come through. He's about 10 seconds back from Andrew Siegel, who is currently in the first place split.
Up next at the start lane is Andrew James out of Colorado Mesa University. Andrew's a finance major, and he hails from Grand Junction, Colorado, and his home mountain is Grand Mesa. This is his fourth national championship. He's 10th at 2017 Nationals. He's looking to move up this year. Coming out of Colorado Mesa University, Andrew James on course.
All right, bib number 44 getting ready to head out. It's going to be Thomas Rizza skiing for Caston University. He's a physical education major coming out of New Paltz, New York. Mountaintop being his home mountain. This is going to be his third national championship.
There's Cale Lindberg coming down through the lap area. Cale's skiing well here. Followed closely behind by Thomas Clayton right behind him. Again, they have another 2.5K to go out and ski out there. And then they'll be back into the finish line pretty quickly here.
Thomas Clayton slides himself into about fourth position there out of the skiers that have come through so far.
In the gate right now, bib number 45, University of Wyoming's Robert Edwards.
All right, bib number 6, just coming through the split in front of the lodge there is Carl Froelich. And a time of about 19.02 for that 5K mark.
Robert Edwards out on course. Robert Edwards from Laramie, Wyoming. Skis for Snowy Range.
All right, next up in the starting area, bib number 47, Derek Hill, skiing for Western State, Colorado University.
46.
Oh, sorry.
Actually, Isaiah Reed, skiing for UMF, is in the gate right now. Just through Matt Lynch, just through the lap finish area. Matt's skiing well here. David Harvey coming down through the lap line.
All right, now we're looking at Derek Hill, bib number 47 from Western State, in the starting area, getting ready to head out. He's an exercise sport science major out of Gunnison, his hometown, Crested Butte.
Gotta love Crested Butte. Both my kids live there. Up next in the start gate, number 48, Einveid Rode. He's a physics major. He's out of Colorado Mesa University. Peter Mallory coming through the lap line. Followed closely behind by Mason Vincent coming through.
All right, Mason Vincent sliding himself into about fourth place. Next up in the starting area, though, is Keegan Cummings wearing bib number 49, skiing for Castleton University. He's a business management major out of Underhill, Vermont. It's going to be his third national championship.
In the start gate next, bib 50, Nate Barat from Cornell University. He's a biology major. And he hails from Canandaigua, New York, and he skis at Bristol Mountain right out there at Honey Eye Falls, Lima area. Great ski tradition in that area. Nate Barat out of Cornell University.
All right, next up, Kalen Mendel, wearing bib number 51, skiing for the University of Vermont. He's a biology and studio art major out of Manchester, Maine. And this is going to be his second national championship.
So we got one of our first finishers coming down the line here.
It's looking like Simon Stouffer skiing for St. Olaf.
Simon Stouffer is going to set the time to beat here.
And not too far behind him, it looks like Charlie Maitland is coming in. Well, Charlie Maitland coming in with the fastest time on that one.
Bib 52, Hunter Alquist. Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb. Hunter Alquist from the United States Air Force Academy. He's a rocket science major from Minnetonka, Minnesota. And he's across the finish. He's out on the start. Bib 53 in the gate. That's Brian Charzan. Brian Charzan, Clarkson University, mechanical engineering major from Clifton Park. And just finishing across the line is number one, Parker Cushing. Brian Charzan's home course is Higley Flow. This is his fourth national championship.
All right, next one coming through the finish line there is going to be bib number 9, Andrew Siegel. All right, Austin Gillespie from Clarkson University. about ready to head out. We're in bib number 54, majors in the art of procrastination, coming out of Massachusetts. Fun fact, he was third in the 2017 Alumni Weekend Beer Mile. Hopefully that training will help him here. All right, bib number 55, Devin Van Bockler, skiing for Castleton University. Ecological Studies major out of Coventry. His home mountain is Mountaintop. This is going to be his first national championship. All right, next up, we're in bib number 56, Tyler Haraldson, skiing for Western State. He's a communications major out of Lakeville. His home mountain is Highland Park. Another first-time national championship competitor. All right, Tyler Haraldson out on course. Next up, we're in bib number 57, is Jake Bradshaw, skiing for Colorado Mesa University. Biology major out of Grand Junction. All right, we're seeing the leader bib come in right now. Followed closely behind by Raymond Metzger. But that was Nate Maddox that we saw coming through. All right, Jake Bradshaw heading out on course. Next up in the gate, we're in bib number 58, Josh Jones for Western State, an environment and sustainability major out of Aurora, Minnesota. Another one, first-time national championship competitor. All right, coming into the finish line right now, we're seeing bib number 8, Lars Hallstrom, skiing for University of Michigan, coming into the finish line. All right, next up, about to head out on course, bib number 59, Benjamin Longenbach, skiing for Clarkson University. He's another athlete, Jim Allitt. He's an engineer of gains. I think we could tell that by looking at the sunglasses and the hat. This is going to be his first national championship, and everybody, it's stiff competition out there with the 2017 Wiffle Beer Player of the Year out there. He would like people to know that he sometimes does well in school. Bib number 60, about ready to head out on course. Elliot Shaw from Western State, Colorado University. He's a recreation and outdoor education major from Tabernash, Colorado. All right, bib number 13 coming in right now. It's going to be Thomas Clayton. All right, a couple more people coming down towards the finish area. Got bibs 10 and 14. It's going to be Cal Lindberg and Matt Lynch coming into the finish line. All right, so all of our athletes are currently out on course. All right, couple people coming through the split area. Trevor Willoughby going through. About 2.5K left to go for Trevor. We've also got bib number 15 coming into the finish line. It's going to be David Harvey. All right, we've got our live timing back up and running. It's looking like for unofficially for our finish line results. In first place, we've got... we're going to hold on to that for right now. A couple more people coming down to the finish line. Bib number 16 and bib number 18 in a sprint for the finish. It looks like Mason Vincent is just going to beat out Peter Mallory by just a hair. All right.
Oh,
All right, a couple more athletes coming through the lap split over there. Bib number 33 and 32. It's going to be Spencer Werjankas and Lucas Adamowicz. Once again, we'd like to remind everybody that we will be back here on the broadcast at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning for the call of the Sprint Championship. All right, coming down to the finish line right now, it's going to be Ian Sarazen, brother of Nigel Sarazen, who we should be seeing not too long as well. But Ian Sarazen finishing up strong. All right, while we've got a second here, we're going to do a couple sponsor reads. First, we'd like to thank Patagonia. Their mission statement is to build the best product, cause no unnecessary harm, use business to inspire and implement solutions to the environmental crisis, and staying true to their core values during 30 plus years in business has helped them create a company that they're proud to run and work for. All right, a couple more people coming down to the finish line here. We've got bib number 19. It's going to be Jordan Freed, followed closely behind by Kevin Geisen. If you take a look right across by the lodge there, we've got bib number 35 heading through the 5K split. That's Spencer Knickerbocker. Next sponsor we'd like to thank is Open Snow. Open Snow provides weather forecasts just for skiers and was started by a meteorologist and USCSA alum from Penn State. They can help you plan your race day, and when you're off the course, they will direct you to the deepest powder. Check it out at opensnow.com or download their free mobile app. All right, just heading through the split right now is bib number 39. That's going to be Gordon Giannini skiing for Western State. About 2.5K to go. Just a few seconds behind him, we're looking at bib number 36. That's Tim Dunn skiing for Clarkson. Clarkson has a large presence here as they're not too far away from Mount Van Hovenberg. Bib number 37, Nigel Sarazen coming through, skiing for the Air Force Academy. And just to remind everybody, we'll be here tomorrow, and we'll also be back Friday and Saturday. Don't miss Saturday's call for the relays. It's the most fun event of the week. After the men's and women's relays, we have a mixed relay that makes absolutely no sense and is essentially just the whose line is it anyway of races. Drew Carey will not be here though, so everyone should show up. Bib number 34 coming across, Connor Maryland, followed closely behind by bib number 28, Ian McGuire. Coming down to the finish line right now, it looks like we've got bib number 17, Tyler Corville. Finishing up strong as the weather seems to be getting just a little bit warmer. Snow might be softening up just a little bit. Just across the way, bib number 42 coming through the split, Tyler Radke, followed closely behind by bib 40 and 38. And that's looking like Thomas Wing and Owen Moland.
Coming in hot to the finish line. That's bib 29 coming in hot to the finish line. Mitchell Holman.
All right, well, we've got our overall results back up on live timing. Top three right now, we're looking at Nate Maddox in first place, and less than a second behind, Mitchell Holman. And then Charlie Maitland currently sits in third.
Bib 25 coming to the finish line. That's Mike Giraldi coming across, followed by bib 24, Josh Sayer.
And bib 26, Roan Hall, coming through not too far behind them. Just across the way, we're looking at bib number 43, just passing their 5K split. That's going to be Andrew James, skiing for CMU.
Rowan Hall slots himself in the 12th spot so far.
All right. Whoa. A little bit of acrobatics going on.
A little bit of freestyle.
Ricky Bobby style. Let's finish this race up backwards. Let's go. That's going to be Tay Tantaviren, of course, doing a little bit of theatrics right before the finish line.
Tay's followed closely by Bib 21.
That's Scott Bolt
coming across the line.
Well, Tay managed to pull that one out and stay upright. And
Tay slots himself in a 24th position so far. Scott Bolt moves up into 22nd position so far. Again, these are all unofficial results.
All right, bib number 23 coming down the final straight. That's Andrew Quirk. Quinoa major.
Andrew coming all the way out here from California. Andrew coming across the line, slotting himself into 20th position. Great finish there. Another finisher coming up hard to the line. One of our Wyoming skiers, bib 31.
It's going to be Trevor Willoughby coming down to the line, finishing up with a nice push. And just across the way, we can see bib number 47 coming through the split. And that's going to be Derek Hill.
Trevor Willoughby moving himself up into that top 10 in the seventh position currently. Once again, kind of highlighting our top five here. We have Mason Vincent in fifth, Andrew Siegel in fourth, Charlie Maitland in third, Mitchell Holman in second, and Nate Maddox holding on to that top spot still.
All right, just across the way, bib number 48 coming through the split. And that's going to be Ivan Andreas Rode.
He's followed right behind by Nick Edwards, heading through the lap area, going on the last 2.5K of this course.
All right, not too far behind them. We're looking at bib number 46, Isaiah Reed.
Kurt Hubner coming down through the lap lane right now. We've got another finisher coming in. This is
Spencer,
bib 33.
Spencer Werjankas.
Spencer pushing hard to that finish line.
Followed not too far behind by Jared Wheeler.
Spencer moves his way up into the top 10 in eighth place currently.
All right. Free skiing down the straightaway. It looks like we've got bib number 32.
Jared Wheeler comes across the finish line, currently sitting in the 22nd position.
All right, Lucas Adamowitz finishing up strong. And it looks like Lucas moved himself into about 17th position.
Shout out to our Wyoming girls out there with a flag. Waving, there they are. They're winning the cheering awards. Guys, you got to step it up for the girls when they're racing next race.
All right, coming down to the finish line here.
Oh, we got a finish coming here. Looks to be exciting. Both these guys pushing hard coming to the finish line.
All right, bib 39 and 35. We've got a battle between Gordon Giannini and Spencer Knickerbocker. It looks like Gordon's going to edge out Spencer.
And Gordon's going to move himself up in the top three right now. He's currently sitting third position. That's a great finish by Gordon. Thomas Rizza moved himself.
All right, just across the way, we've got bib number 44, Thomas Rizza coming through the split.
Thomas Rizzo moving himself into 45th position. Oh, no, Thomas Rizzo is coming through the lap lane.
All right, bib number 37 coming down into the finish line right now. Nigel Sarrazin finishing up. Just across the way, we're looking at bib number 51. Kalen Mendahl coming through the lap split, followed closely behind by bib number 53, Brian Trazen. Another Clarkson skier coming down to the finish here. That's going to be bib number 36, Tim Dunn. Finishing up strong.
Tim Dunn slotting himself in a 23rd position across the line. We just had Hunter Alquist go through the lap lane. Another finisher coming down through here. Bib number 42. That's Tyler Radke coming up the line, pushing hard all the way through the finish line. Tyler Radke slots himself in the top five. Great finish there. Austin Gillespie coming through on the lap lane. Bib number 54 over in the lap lane. Austin's coming through over in the lap. Another lap racer coming through. Will Loeffner coming through. Bib 34 coming up to the finish line.
That's going to be Connor Maryland finishing up. The Hunter Orange.
Coming across the finish line, that's bib 40. That's Thomas Wing across the line.
Just across the way, we've got bib number 56 coming through the split. That's Tyler Haraldson.
And there's bib 38, Owen Mollin across the line. Owen slotting himself into 27th position currently.
And Owen is followed closely behind by Andrew James of CMU.
Andrew James slotting himself in the top 10 so far. He's sitting in ninth position right now, but still a lot of racers out there and a lot of racing to be done here.
All right, bib number 49 coming through the 5K split, Keegan Cummings.
And we got bib 28 pushing to the finish line.
Ian McGuire finishing up strong.
We'll recap of our current top five. In fifth place right now, sitting Tyler Radke, followed right ahead of him is Charlie Maitland in fourth. Third place, Gordon Giannini sitting in third place. Second place currently, Mitchell Holman. And leading right now is Nate Maddox.
Well, bib 50 is coming through the split right now. That's Nate Barrett.
He's followed by Josh Jones coming through the lap area right now.
Well, we've got a second here. We'd like to thank another one of our sponsors, Apex Ski Boots. Apex Ski Boots blend the comfort, custom fit, and warmth of a snowboard boot into a revolutionary open chassis design that is unlike any other ski boot on the market. Laterally extremely stiff, perfect for today's side cut skis, you can snowboard on them too. To celebrate this new sponsorship, Apex is now offering their deepest discounts to USCSA athletes and coaches. To find out more and view their product lineup, please visit apexskiboots.com.
It looks like a fast finisher coming in, bib number 47. That's Derek Hill coming across the line. And Derek's going to move his way up here, and looks like he's placed himself up in the top 10 in ninth position.
All
bib
right.
48 coming across the line.
Bib 48 is going to be Ivan Andreas Rode, skiing for Castleton. Nope, I'm sorry, CMU.
And Einvind hens his way up into seventh position so far. Top five is staying pretty steady here. We still got some racers out in the course. We're going to challenge for those.
Well, less than a second between Nate Maddox and Mitchell Holman in first and second place.
Want to give a little shout out to another of our sponsors here, Bag Bomb, founded in $18.99 in the rugged Northeast Kingdom of Vermont. Bag Bomb is great for chapped lips and dry skin and works wonders in a winter. We hope that everyone at the Collegiate National Championships is enjoying their free samples at Lake Placid this week. Gotta love Bag Bomb.
All right, bib number 59 coming through the 5K split. That's Benjamin Longenbach skiing for Clarkson. Double pulling his way down the back straight.
Looking strong. Getting a little encouragement from his coach out there, Jim Ellett.
All right, bib number 45 coming down into the finish area right now. That's going to be Nick Edwards skiing for University of Wyoming.
And those Wyoming girls cheering him into the finish line. He's going to be followed right up by bib 46.
That's going to be Isaiah Reed skiing for UMF.
Nick Edwards slots himself in the 30th position currently, and Isaiah Reed goes up in the 28th position.
All right, next up on our sponsors, Love Your Melon. Love Your Melon is an apparel brand dedicated to giving a hat to every child battling cancer in America, as well as supporting nonprofit organizations that lead the fight against pediatric cancer. 50% of profits are donated to children's cancer research and family support.
Coming to the finish line, we got bib 41. That's Kurt Hubner across the line, skiing for Cornell. Great finish today by Kurt. Moves his way up into 43rd position right now. Once again, beautiful day here at Mount Van Hovenberg. The course is great. Workers have done a lot of work over the last 2 weeks trying to get this course ready. Made a lot of snow with their snow machine. And hopefully the racers are having a good time out here. So today's race is a skate race. We're going to move tomorrow, switch gears a little bit. Short distance, 1.5 kilometers, and that'll be a classic sprint championships. Great format. Everybody will race first to get a time, then we'll take the top 30 and move them on into the heats, and they'll advance through the semifinals and then finally the final. So some exciting racing. Make sure you're back out here tomorrow. See us for the sprint races, and that will be starting off at 10 a.m. with a prologue, with a time prologue, and then we'll move into, at noontime, we'll move into the exciting, where they go 6-on-6 head-to-head for the heats, the semis, and the finals.
All right, one more Clarkson skier coming down the final straightaway, bib number 53. And that's going to be Brian Trazen. Hope I'm pronouncing that correctly.
Charzan.
Finishing up strong.
Brian formerly skied for Shenandoah, one of the powerhouses in Section 2, just down the road from Lake Placid here.
All right, a couple more skiers coming down the line here. Bib number 51, Callan Mendahl. Heading to the finish line, followed closely by Hunter Alquist. All right, we've got about 10 skiers left out there. I'd like to remind everybody, we're going to pick this broadcast back up at 9 a.m. tomorrow. All right, we got bib 44 coming down to the finish line. It's going to be Thomas Rizza. Followed closely behind by bib number 54, Austin Gillespie. Another Clarkson skier. Seem to be well represented here at these national championships. All right, coming through the split area right now, bib number 55. Devin Van Bockler. About 2.5K left to go in the race for Devin. All right, we'd like to thank another sponsor, Lakes Dental Care. Lakes Dental Care is proud to partner with USCSA and promote optimal oral health for all of its members. They have you covered at this year's USCSA Collegiate National Championships by providing great oral hygiene products in the athlete welcome bags, and one of their dentists will be on site at Lake Placid all week. Check them out on Facebook, Instagram, or at their website, lakesdentalcare.com. All right, 56, bib number 56, Tyler Haraldson. Coming into the line. And Tyler moves himself into about 35th position. All right, and appropriately after Lakes Dental Care, we have our another sponsor, Monster Energy Drinks. Tear into a can of the meanest energy drink on the planet, Monster Energy. It's the ideal combo of the right ingredients in the right proportion to deliver the big bad buzz that only Monster can. Unleash the beast.
Jared, you unleash the beast. Another finisher coming down the line, pushing hard. We got bib 58. That's Josh Jones across the line. Josh Jones slotting himself into 35th position. Bib number 49 coming into the finish line. That's Keegan Cummings. Keegan Cummings coming across the line in 53rd position. And that's bib 57 across the line. That's Jake Bradshaw. Jake Bradshaw moving himself up into 42nd position. Here's bib 60, our last starter for today, but not our last finisher, Elliot Shaw, the strong finish. And right behind him, bib 50 coming through. Bib 50, that's Nate Barrett. Elliot Shaw moving himself up into the top 30 in 31st position. And Nate Barrett into 56th position across the line. Two or three more finishers still out there. Right now, looking at our top five. Hasn't changed much in the last little bit, but we have Tyler Radke sitting in fifth place. Charlie Maitland sitting in fourth place. Third place, Gordon Giannini sitting in third place. Second place, Mitchell Holman. And your current leader right now, Nate Maddox. Nate Maddox sitting there just a second ahead, a little less than a second ahead of Mitchell Holman. Coming up to the line, bib 59.
That's going to be Benjamin Longenbach skiing for Clarkson. You can spot those Clarkson skiers a long way off of those green suits.
And Benjamin slots himself into 44th position currently. Just waiting on two more finishers here.
All right, we'd also like to thank Zevo Optics. Zevo Optics is a ski and snowboard goggle company based in the beautiful North Central Cascades Mountains town of Leavenworth, Washington. They strive to deliver the highest quality product to the customer with the best warranty in the business and a no-nonsense, no-questions-asked return policy at a much better price than our competitors. Don't confuse their pricing with quality, as they guarantee their product is equal or superior to the competition at half the price. We'd also like to thank Cabot Cheese. I wish we had samples of Cabot Cheese up here. But Cabot Cheese has been owned and operated by real farmers, has been making award-winning cheddar cheese and other dairy products since 1919. Going on almost 100 years.
Here comes another finisher. Coming up the finish line. Let's hear some noise here, people.
All right, it looks like bib number 30, Will Loeffner, coming in.
Come on, Will, you can make it. Here we go. Will Loeffner coming across the finish line. And Will Loeffner finishes up today. Great finish, Will.
Well, it looks like the weather this week might be throwing us a little bit of a curveball later on, but we will be back tomorrow, no question about it, for the Sprint Championship. We'd like to thank everybody for tuning in so far. It's been a fun broadcast. This is a great area. Trails are in a great condition. If you're up here at all for the championships, grab some skis and come on over.
Like I said, tomorrow we have some exciting racing action going on tomorrow with the sprint races. If you haven't ever seen a sprint race before, it's really great to watch. They'll start out and the top 30 will move into heats, and then they'll go six against six and move their way up through. And it's all about placing and skiing fast. So,
well, anything can happen on those corners.
You never know.
It's like NASCAR. Everybody NASCAR. Comes down to watch the wrecks. But we're hoping for good weather tomorrow, and we should definitely have some extra snow a little later on in the week. We're looking at anywhere from 4 to 12 inches up here Wednesday into Thursday. So if you brought your downhill skis with you, definitely head over and check out Whiteface. If you've never been down into Lake Placid before, there's some great restaurants, great bars, nice place to walk around, a bunch of great stores on Main Street.
So bib 41, if you need your pole back, we have the pole, and it'll be right outside. I got that one a little wrong. Anybody who needs a pole that gave a poll to bib 41, we have it here at the timing building. It will be sitting right outside the door at the timing building. So if you were nice enough to give a poll to bib 41, it's sitting right outside the timing building. All right, so we're going to go through our top 10 here. Just give you a little indication. Again, these results are unofficial, but right now, unofficially in 10th place, we have Derek Hill. At 9th place, Kevin Geisen. In 8th place, Mason Vincent. In 7th place, Einvid Andreas Rode. In 6th place, Andrew Siegel. In 5th place, Tyler Radke. 4th place, Charlie Maitland. 3rd place, Gordon Giannini. 2nd place, Mitchell Holman, and right now your leader, unofficially, Nate Maddox.
Well, our top 10 is separated out by almost exactly 1 minute, and 1st and 2nd place are separated by less than a second. So it should be good competition the rest of the week with a top 10 that's this close together.
So don't forget, follow us on TV here, and the broadcast will be up on the USCSA skiing website. We want to wrap things up here. A great day here for the first day of the 2018 National Championships for the USCSA. Come back tomorrow, and we'll see you tomorrow for the sprint races.
All right, thanks for tuning in, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow.
One in Bend, Oregon, and Oregon in 2015. Now in Lake Placid, will the table?
Yep, up on our feet now. Here's some vice temperatures.
All right, that heat's feeling ready.
Riders ready.
Out
attention.
Yeah, buddy. Yeah, Cole.
Yeah.
We're never gonna run and hide. If I get tired and say that I wanna change my mind, pull me in a circle so I can change. We're not finished. One more.